Good afternoon, ladies and gentlemen, and welcome to Augie Schmidt Field. For today's game between the University of Wisconsin Whitewater Warhawks and the Carthage College Firebirds, let's meet today's starting lineups. First, for the visiting Warhawks, leading off and playing left field, number 15, Matt Scullin. Batting second and playing right field, number 13, Jacob DeMeyer. Batting third and playing first base, number 34, Donovan Brendel. Batting fourth and playing third base, number 18, Adam Cootway. Batting fifth and the DH, number 24, Sam Payden. Batting sixth and playing center field, number 8, Alex Nunzera. Batting seventh and playing second base, number 5, Bennett Fraser. Batting eighth and playing shortstop, number 3, Daryl Jackson. Batting ninth and playing catcher, number 29, Ryan Norton. The starting pitcher for the Warhawks is number 33, Danny Hopper. The head coach for UW-Whitewater is John Vodenlich. He is assisted by Steve Bartline, Mike Aiello, Armando Hernandez, Tom Klatwitter, and Mark Fuller. And now the starting lineup for your Carthage College Firebirds. Leading off and playing left field, number 19, Cody Tostrud. Batting second and playing second base, number 14, Cody Kreckling. Batting third and playing shortstop, number 31, Colin Callahan. Batting fourth and the DH, number 11, Joe Zulager. Batting fifth and playing catcher, number 10, A.J. Gasa. Batting sixth and playing first base, number 28, P.J. Moser. Batting seventh and playing right field, number 30, Mike Sesla. Batting 8th and playing 3rd base, number 12, Matt Felber. Batting 9th and playing center field, number 36, Chucky Smith. The starting pitcher for the Firebirds is number 23, Dante Garaccio. The head coach for Carthage is Augie Schmidt. He is assisted by John LaQuay, John Hasser, Joe Stevens, and Keith Kutzler. Fans, at this time we ask that you please rise and remove your caps as we honor America with the playing of our national anthem.
Good afternoon and welcome to Augie Schmidt Field, home of the Carthage College Firebirds, as today they take on the UW-Whitewater Warhawks. Carthage comes into the game 7-22, riding an unfortunate 11-game losing streak, looking to break that today. UW-Whitewater comes in at 17-11 with a 4-game losing streak of their own. Starting lineups today, for Whitewater. Batting first and in left field, Matt Skolin. Batting second and in right field, Jacob DeMeyer. At first and batting third, Donovan Brandel. At third and batting cleanup, Adam Cootway. Designated hitter is Sam Payton. He's batting fifth. Batting sixth and in center field, Alex Noreja. Batting seventh and at second base, Bennett Frazier. Batting eighth and playing shortstop, Daryl Jackson. And batting ninth and behind the plate is Ryan Norton. Pitching for Carthage this afternoon is Dante Gracio. And for Carthage, playing left field, batting first, Cody Tostrud. Batting second and at second, Cody Kreckling. Batting third and at short is Colin Callahan. Cleanup is a designated hitter, Joe Zuliger. Batting fifth and at catcher, A.J. Geisha. Batting sixth and at first base, P.J. Moser. Batting seventh and in right field, Mike Sesla. Batting eighth at third base, Matt Felber. And batting ninth and in center field, Chucky Smith. First batter up, top of the first for Matt Skolin, the left fielder. And we're underway with a high and inside pitch for ball one. Matt Skolin's a sophomore out of Downers Grove, Illinois. Chopped that one to second. Freckling makes easy work of that for the first out.
Now batting four Hawks, right fielder number 13.
Next up,
Jacob DeMeyer.
Jacob DeMeyer. Hitting 402 on the year. Played all 27 games so far for Whitewater. That pitch is in there for a strike. Count that 1-1. 102 at bats for DeMeyer this season so far with 41 hits, 24 RBIs. Takes a crack, swing at that one. Comes up empty. 1-2 now. Third, fourth pitch on the way is fouled back. Count remains at 1-2. DeMeyer, a junior out of Rhinelander, Wisconsin. That one also fouled back. 1-2. Pitch on the way, that hit sharply back to the pitcher. Got a glove on it, slowed it down. Callahan still able to come up with the play there.
Now batting
there's
for the
two
Warhawks,
down.
First baseman number 34. Donovan Brandel.
Looked like Gracio might have slowed that down a bit too much. But Callahan still able to get there in time for that second out. Next up we have Donovan Brandel, first baseman. First pitch inside. Second pitch on the way is in there for called strike. 1-1. Randall, also a junior out of Rudolph, Wisconsin. So does some pitching as well. That third pitch fouled back. 1-2 now. Gracio looking for the 1-2-3 top of the first. gets him swinging. Strike out, and he does. Make short work of the top of the first there.
Attention fans,
so after a half inning, no hits for UW-Whitewater in that inning. Also no runs. Carthage up to bat. As we head to the bottom of the first, Danny Hopper will be taking the mound for Whitewater. He brings in a 4.7 ERA. One win. 8 appearances. This is his first start of the year. He's pitched 15 and a third to this point. Went up 23 hits. 12 runs, 8 of those earned, 16 strikeouts, and only one walk to his credit.
Leading off
first
for
Carthage,
left
Cody
fielder,
Tostrud.
Cody Tostrud.
He is a senior. Out of Kenosha, Bradford High School. Batting 322 on the year. Played in and started all 29 games so far. That one is low, look for a check swing. And I guess he did go around, that's strike one. That one's fouled hard on the third base side. Down 0-2 here quickly. Third pitch on the way. That also fouled down the third base side. 39 hits for Tostrud on the year so far. Took that one inside. 1-2 now. Hopper, the delivery, that one's low side. 2-2 now. Carthage looking to get off to a good start here this game. Nice crack up the middle there. Easy single for Tostrud. Gets the first batter of the inning on board.
Now batting for the Firebirds, second baseman,
Cody Crickling will now step to the
Cody
plate.
Crickling.
Crickling is a sophomore out of Racine. Hitting 295 on the year. That one also not quite as hard as Tostrud's, but does the work for another single. On the first pitch,
Carthage
in early business here at the bottom of the first.
Colin Callahan.
Two on, nobody out for Colin Callahan. Shortstop today. excuse me, also a sophomore out of Lake Zurich. It's foul down the first base side. Callahan, the highest batting average for Carthage this year at 380. He's also played all 29 games. Shows the bunt. Bunts it to the short side. He got a little confused there initially. And that one gets in there. Safe. And we are full.
For the Firebirds, DH number 11.
For Joe Zuliger. See what he can do with nobody out. Base is full. That one is ripped between first and second. That's going to score one. Kreckling holds at third. Bases remain loaded.
Catcher number 10, A.J. Gasa.
For A.J. Gasa. Oh, Carthage. Dream start to break their 11-game losing streak to this point. Four hits to Carthage's name. First two batters to center. And Callahan with a nifty bunt to the shortstop side. Jackson couldn't make the throw in time. And then Zuliger with a nice single to right. And it's already 1-0 Carthage. Still nobody out. Quick discussion at the mound with Hopper. Again, his first start of the year. Not what he was envisioning. But Carthage loves it. Oh, Gasa in there. He takes a swing at it, misses. 0-1. Gasa, a freshman out of West Chicago, Illinois. That one he takes low and outside. 1-1 the count. Third pitch on the way. That one is hit high. Should be caught out in center. Para, it is. And Kreckling tags. And scores.
For the Firebirds.
So the sacrifice
baseman,
for Gasa.
DJ Moser.
Now leaves third open. Then on first and second. With one down now for P.J. Moser. Take the first fur ball. No delivery now for Hopper. That one is hitting the gap between short and third. That's going to score another run. Now 3-0 Carthage. Still only one down. Callahan was able to get all the way from second on that single.
For the Firebirds, right fielder number 30.
By Moser.
Mike Tesla.
Mike Tesla up now. Seventh batter of the inning for Carthage. Runner's still at first and second. Strike one on the first pitch. One delivery. That's good rip that missed. 0-2 now. For Sessa Jr. out of Lamont, Illinois. Sessa swings at that one. Three strikes.
Not
Sessa, two down now.
Third
for Carthage.
Baseman, number 12, Matt Felber.
The third baseman, Matt Felber, up now. Two out on the inning. Felber, seeing if he can't help extend the lead for Carthage. That one is foul on the right-hand side. It's the top of the dugout. 0-1 the count. Felber, sophomore, out of Kenosha, Wisconsin. In trail for high school. That one catches the outside part of the plate. 0-2 now. Hopper trying to end this inning for Whitewater. That one will be fouled. Out of play to the right side. Still 0-2. Two down. And a first and second. That one is taken outside as well. 1-2 now. That is strike three, swung on and missed.
But the score at the end of the first inning is
Carthage
three,
does some damage in the
nothing.
Bottom part of the first inning. Five hits, three runs, two left on base, and after one, Carthage three, Whitewater nothing. Horacio back to work for Carthage in the top half of the second inning.
Adam Cootway.
Adam Cootway, the first batter he will face here. 1-2-3 in the top half of the first. They continue that good work here in the second as a ball one is thrown. Horacio with an 8.83 ERA on the year. One win, two losses. His sixth appearance. As that one's in their first strike. 1-1 now. Garcia's given up 25 hits, 22 runs in his five appearances so far. That one takes for a ball. 2-1 now. Garcia's thrown 27 strikeouts. Issued 13 walks so far. That one is on the outside. Gets the call. 2-2. Cootway, a junior out of DePere, Wisconsin. Takes that one. And the count is full. tapped foul. Do it again. Bootway hitting 386 on the air. Played in 25 games for Whitewater. Up pitch is low. That was close. Kootway held off and trots over to first. So the first man's aboard for Whitewater. Brings up Sam Payton, designated hitter for Whitewater. It takes a nice lead. First pitch outside, ball one. Also outside, perhaps a bit low. Gracio thought he had that one, but count is 2-0 now. That one is ripped to third. Felber not able to come up with it. And Kootway makes his way all the way to third.
I'm batting for the Warhawks. Center fielder number 8, Alex Nelsaroff.
So now we got runners at the corners for Whitewater. Nobody out, top of the second. Whitewater looking to trim this lead early in the top half of the second. Alex Reha at the plate. He chops that short. Bobbled, and all will be safe there. That most likely will be an error on Callahan.
I'm batting for the Warhawks, second baseman number 5, Bennett Fraser.
As runners now at first and second for Whitewater. One run came in as Bennett Fraser stepped to the plate. Junior out of Oconto, Wisconsin. That one gets away from catcher. Runners will move to second and third. See how that one gets scored. Asa couldn't come up with that one. Runners to advance. For a ball, 2-0 the count. Barassi already in the jam here. That one's called strike on the outside part of the plate. 2-1 the count. Frazier hit 245 on the year. He's played in all 27 Whitewater games. That one is ripped between first and second. That most likely will, nope, scores one. Nahara held at third. I thought he might go.
Not batting but for the Warhawks.
Most wisely stays at third, given there are no outs. Frazier with the single to right. Leaves runners at the corners. Nobody out. Daryl Jackson, the shortstop, stepped to the plate. Takes that one high and outside. Want to know the count? Jackson, a sophomore out of Milwaukee. Second pitch on the way. Runner for first is in there easily with the steal. Bennett Fraser. No trouble stealing that bag. Field on the air. Been safe on all six attempts. That one nicely in there for strike one and two. Three-two Carthage. Early lead already trimmed to one. That one is just kind of pushed between short and third. That one will score two. And he digs in for second, easily in there. Jackson brings in two. Just kind of steered that one nicely between short and third.
Catcher number 29, a gap. Ryan Norton.
Nahara and Frazier come in. That will give Whitewater the lead at 4-3. As a conference now ensues with nobody out here in the top half of the second. It's kind of a nifty piece of hitting there by Jackson. Knew right where to take that one to get the runners from second and third in. So the sixth batter for Whitewater in the inning awaits his turn to see if he can't further add to the Whitewater lead. Ryan Norton, the catcher, senior out of Fond du Lac. Norton batting 151 on the year. Played in 21 games. 8 hits. 6 RBIs. 53 plate appearances. All right, talk is over. Outs were hopefully discussed for Carthage. That one is hit to right. Tesla lost it in the sun, and it just was on the fair part of the line. Pretty unlucky there for Carthage. I thought even if he didn't come up with that, it was going to land foul, but just inside the line as Tesla couldn't handle the sun on that one. And another run comes around for Whitewater. Now the fifth of the game. Norton made it all the way to third on that one. We're back to the top part of the order. His first pitch taken for a ball. Matt Stolen, the batter. Grounded out second on his first appearance. That on the count 2-0 here early. Still nobody out here. That one is high and inside. 3-0 the count. Norton on third as the fourth pitch does not get in there for a strike. Four pitch walk issued by Rossio.
Right fielder number 13, Skolin. Jacob DeMeyer.
We'll trot to first. Now runners on the corners for Jacob DeMeyer. He grounded out short. His first appearance. Also a ball. Close from here. Fired and not. Gracio the strike on that one. toss over to first. Gets stolen back. On low, outside. 2-0 the count for DeMeyer. Whitewater up by two. Third pitch is in there, also for a ball. 3-0 now the count. Fourth pitch now. Also low. Another walk issued. Also with four straight balls. That will load the bases. And Donovan Brandel will have them loaded as we are welcoming the second Carthage pitcher for the day. He walks into a bases loaded, no out situation with Donovan Brandel. 16 RBIs on his season, set to come up next. Pitcher is to be Brandon Roberts, 6'1 freshman out of Sominok, Illinois. As we'll step aside for just a moment.
Pitching for the Firebirds, number 24, Brendan Roberts. Batting.
All right, let's reset here, Carthage.
Donovan Brandel.
Base is loaded. Brendan Roberts, your new pitcher on the mound. 5.59 ERA on the year. This is his 10th appearance. 19 and a third innings pitched to date. Giving up 25 hits, 17 runs. 14 strikeouts as the first pitch in their first strike, and 7 walks issued to date. Donovan Brandel struck out his first time, bobbled a bit, but nowhere for any runner to go as it's 1-1 the count. Third pitch on the way is ripped to second. Looks to turn two and does. Crackling the Callahan to Moser.
For the Warhawks, third baseman number 18.
For the 4-6-3 double play. Run did come across for Whitewater. Now 6-3. First pitch taken for a ball. So a runner now left at third after the double play. Adam Hootway, who started this inning, with a walk. Takes his second fall for 2-0. Victory, Whitewater, top of the second. 2-0 count, two outs. Pitch on the way, high. 3-0 now. Put away the first runner across the plate for Whitewater in this inning. To add with another, but take a four ball walk instead. Just
designated hitter number 24.
Just as he started
Sam
the inning
Hayden.
With a walk. Continues the inning around with another walk. Runners at the corners now. Sam Hayden. Single his first time up. That one in their first strike. 0-1. Hayden with the largest average on Whitewater's side, 405 clip. He's hitting it, 17 hits on the air. That one's swung at, 0-2. Well, Robert's doing his work so far. Came in, bases loaded, nobody out. Got Brandel to hit into a double play to get two down. That one fouled back. Gains 0-2. Hayden also came across, played for the second run of Whitewater, second inning. Roberts looks to end it. That one is lifted into right. Tesla is there. No trouble this time. Inning comes to a close. So, damage done by the Whitewater side in that top half of the second.
You go home with a free coupon for
four hits,
Culver's ice cream,
six runs,
courtesy of Culver's.
Two left on base, and after inning and a half,
hits, you win a coupon
six
for free cheese curds,
to three Whitewater.
This depends on which happens first. Good luck. Leading off for the Firebirds, center fielder number 36, Ducky Smith.
All right, bottom half of the second. Carthage entered the inning up 3-0, now find themselves down 6-3. As Chucky Smith in there takes ball one. Second pitch in there for called strike 1-1. Chucky Smith, sophomore out of Creed, Illinois. Another called strike. Now 1-2. Fourth pitch. Go by on the outside. 2-2 now. One is chopped right back to the mound. Easy play for Hopper. One down for Carthage. That'll bring back up the top of the order for Carthage. Kostrud in there. Single for him in his first appearance. Up to center field. Taking low, 2-0. Third pitch is in there for a strike, 2-1. Pretty nice day out there today. Not a cloud in the sky. Sun shining down. That one is ripped to short. One bounce. Frazier couldn't come up with it. Hard hit single for Toastrude.
Now batting for the Firebird.
He's now 2-2 on the day.
Number 14, Cody Kreckling.
As Cody Kreckling now steps in. Lower velocity pitch didn't remain high, and it's 1-0. Kreckling also with a single to center, his first time up. Strike. 1-1 the count. Side, 2-1. Kreckling hitting 295 on the air. Cross over to first. Kostrud on his heels. Kostrud has attempted 3 stolen bases this year. Successful one. Check swing there. Held it up. 3-1 the count. Temperature hovering around 50 degrees here in Kenosha. Today the sun is definitely helping those in the stands. Sure. On the count is taken. Four ball and a walk.
Now batting for the Firebird.
Toastrude and Kreckling now aboard.
Colin Callahan.
For Colin Callahan. Kind of a nifty bunt to the shortstop side that been there for a hit last time. We could do with runners first and second. Going back to the screen. And that one. A little under it. Came back. Screen. And that one is in there. 0-2 now. And takes that one looking. That's a strikeout.
Not batting for the Firebirds. Designated
Callahan with
11,
a bit of a shake of the
Joe
head there.
Zuliger.
Sure. Disappointed in himself or with the call, but either way. Two outs now. Joe Zuliger. Is inside. 1-0. Zuliger drove in a run his first time up with a single to right. First single would be nice here for Carthage. Low one in the dirt. Lost for a second by Norton, but damage done. 2-0 the count. Called by the ump. screen. 2-1 now. Elger coming into the game with 21 RBIs. Tied for the lead on Carthage. Toss back to second. See if Toaster is paying attention, and he was. Hopper sets the liver, and that one is outside. To the left-handed Zuliger. Hopper's thrown 40 pitches to this point, giving up 6 hits, 3 runs. Delivers again outside, and that'll load it up.
Now batting for the Firebirds, catcher number 10, A.J. Gesa.
Gesa aboard. See what he can do with bases loaded here. He's got 6 RBIs on the year. That one is lifted high into left. Going back, not a chance. That would be a grand slam. 4, count them, 4 runs coming across for Gesa. Only a modest look by Skolin out there and left for that one. Never a doubt.
Now batting for the Firebird. First baseman number 28.
Piece of hitting there by Gesa. Suddenly, Carthage finds itself up 7-6. Postrud, Kreckling, and Zuliger all get home on the grand slam by Gesa. 0-1 now to P.J. Moser. Chopped on the right field side, out of play. Oh, and 2 now to Moser. 2 out here in the bottom half of the second. Ball 1 taken. He saw a battle to this point. Carthage now up by 1 after the grand slam. That one's fouled down the third base side. 1-2 still. Take for a ball, 2-2. Moser with a hit, his first time up. Left field. Another rip to second. Fraser slides into it and does get the out. But Carthage behind the bat.
A.J. Gesa
retains the lead.
Whitewater 6.
Grand slam for us all. 7-6. Carthage after 2. All right, we're back. Top half of the third. Warhawks up to bat. Alex Hera in there. If Whitewater retakes the lead. Hera reached on an error in that second inning. And it scored one for Whitewater. 1-1 the count. Robert's still in there pitching for Carthage. Going 11 pitches to this point. And that one's going to be looped into... Oh, excuse me. Skolin. Oh, I'm sorry, Toastrude. Pardon me. In there for the diving catch. Thought that was going to be blooped in, but... Speak too fast. Toastrude dives. Takes away a hit from Hera. One down now for Whitewater. Seemed like it was just going to sink in there for a signal, but luckily for Carthage. Toastrude had other ideas. Gets the first out. Bennett Frazier now up. 0-1 in the count. That high, 1-1. That one's taken. Strike, 1-2. Frazier with the single to right his first time up. Drove in a run. Gonna be chopped to Kreckling. Roberts running over. Gets the play. Nicely done by Carthage there. For the 4-1 force out.
Daryl Jackson.
So Roberts come in, settle down Carthage a bit here. Already has two outs on the top of the third. Little Jackson in there. Whitewater. That one foul down the right hand side. Jackson also with a hit his first time up for two runs. Doubled it up. Top half second. One is outside. 2-1. Deals. Another shot to the right side. Foul. 2-2 now. Two down. Nobody on. Carthage leads by one. Top half third. Robert to put this inning to a close. Slow. Full count now. Jackson's second start of the year. Nine games previously played. It's another one fouled to the right-hand side. Bit of a duel going on here between Robert and Jack. On the way. Oh, seem concerned about starting his trot to first, but does get the walk issued.
Ryan Norton.
A little life for Whitewater here on top of the third. As Ryan Norton steps to the plate. It would seem like it was going to be a caught ball to right field last time. Fortunately, Cecil couldn't come up with it. He got all the way to third. Oh, won the count. Toss back to first. Norton drove in a run his first time up as well. That one's low. Jackson's going to dig for second. Not in time. Not sure if Jackson would have gone if that ball had been picked up. Seemed like Kiesa did the best he could with that one, given how short of the plate it was. But it does put a runner in scoring position. As Roberts tosses a looked at strike there. 1-2. Two down. Hit. One is up towards. Oh, he couldn't come up with it. Thought he might have had it. Kind of got himself a little bit twisted up. Kind of smiles a bit about that one. Knows he probably should have had it. He was right up against the screen there. And again, not a cloud in the sky to cover the any sun issues the players might have today. So that leaves Norton alive. Ball and two strikes. Pitch is swung on and missed. Strike three, Roberts.
Attention fans, the
tosses a scoreless inning there.
Just cross the bridge to the east.
And after two and a half, Carthage still leads 7-6.
Pitching for the Warhawks, number 25, Carson Resser. Leading off the Firebird. Right fielder number 30.
Pitching change as we head to the top of the third. Carson Resser, freshman out of Waupun, Wisconsin. that's the fake. Mike Sessler, his first batter. Pitch outside, 1-0. Sessler strikeout, first time up. Flips it to first, should be an easy play for Brandel. And it is, one down.
I'm batting for the Firebirds, third baseman number 12, Matt Felber.
Wrestler with his third appearance of the year. 5-4 ERA. First pitch. Felber is chopped to the first base side. 0-1. Felber also struck out his first time up. Takes a called strike. 0-2 quickly. Felber in his seventh. Eight. One is hit foul sharply to the right base side. First base side. Wrestler, inning and two-thirds to his credit this season so far, as that one is lined pretty directly to Frazier, the second baseman.
Now
to take a few
Firebirds
steps over to the first base side.
Center fielder, number 36, Bucky
makes
Smith.
Easy work out of Felber there. 2 down now. Bucky Smith is aboard. Grounded out back pitcher. First time up. Ooh, that one curved nicely in there. For a strike. Looked like that was going to be inside, but movement over the plate. Strike. Get on that one. Low. 1-1. Also low and outside as well. Shout on the Carthage side. I'd appreciate that call. 2-1. 2-2 now as he chops it over to the Whitewater dugout. Ready, delivers, going outside, full count. Press, strike out, farthest. He gets Smith to chop that one, follow on the third base side. We'll do the full count again. 3-2. Delivers. Strikes him out. Got him looking. Smith tried to play it off and start walking
score
his way over to first.
Carthage 7,
not to be, however.
Whitewater 6.
So it's a quick inning of work for Bresser. No runs, no hits, nobody left on. Remains 7-6 Carthage as we head to the bottom of the third. another pitching change in for Carthage.
As
we head to the top of the fourth. Nathan Schnabel in for Carthage, senior out of Kenosha. He replaces Brennan Roberts, who pitched two innings, threw 30 pitches, faced seven batters, strikeout, and two walks issued as the first batter up for Whitewater. Matt Skolin rips the first pitch to the right-hand side. Therefore, an easy single. That was the top of the lineup for Whitewater. A second in the batting order. Jacob DeMeyer steps in. First one foul back at the screen. Meyer walked and grounded out in his first appearances. Finds that one foul, but hit well. But down 0-2 in the count now. Thankful crossed early on that one. Hit hard. Oh, 2 the count as there's a toss over to first. Golan trots back. Second toss as well. Golan has stolen 6 bases on the year. That one is hit sharply into the left. Toaster there. But the single drops.
Now batting for the Warhawks.
So 2 batters aboard quickly for Whitewater. Single to right, followed by a single to left. Donovan Brandle in there. Struck out and has hit to a double play as well. Nobody out here in the top of the fourth. That ball's low. Going to get away from Gesa. Runners advance. Second and third. Know the count, Brandel. Looks at the chop now. Takes second ball. What else? Brandel with 16 RBIs on the year. Set that one for a strike. There by Schnabel. Low one on the outside. Still across the plate. Still hit that right back. Schnabel able to hold the runners. Nice play there. For the first out of the fourth.
Third base and number 18, Adam.
Oh, Adam Cootway now aboard. Walk to his credit today. Just hit to the right side. Just shoots foul. 0-1. appearance of the season. 4.15 ERA. Issued. 1-1 the count now. Outside 2-1. Dolan on third, DeMeyer on second. One down here. Pitch is going to get over the first baseman's head for a single. That's going to score two. Nice piece of hitting there by Kootway. Two runs driven in by him. And Whitewater reclaims the lead at 8-7. Loop that one right between first and right. Chance to get it. Hayden there for Whitewater. Oh, and Kootway gets caught trying to steal. Nicely done. Misjudged. Schnabel's going to throw it. And as he was running towards second, Schnabel over to Moser and toss it to Kreckling for the second out of the inning. Base is cleared as Payton lifts that one far into the left field. That one is gone. Well, at least you can say it is only a one-run shot and not a two-run shot for Payton. As Kootway got caught stealing just before that. But it is a home run for Payton. Doubt on that one. As Nahara's in there. Sarah, pardon me. He takes a strike, 0-1. That's low, 1-1. That one is going right over to Kreckling. Bit of a low throw, but gets him to end the inning. Got some damage done by Whitewater there. Three hits in the inning and three runs as well with the solo shot by Payton to finish the inning. And played 3.5. Whitewater now leads 9-7 over Carthage. Thank you. bottom of the fourth now.
Cody Kostrud
up. Top of the order for Carthage. Down two. First pitch is low and inside. 1-0. Kostrud with a couple of hits on the day. Both pretty sharp singles in the center field area. That one, right inside, and catcher can't even put a glove on it. Rolls back towards the fence. 2-0. One is high and outside. You know now. And that one's in there for a strike. Kostrud made a slight movement to first. Thought that might be called a ball. Kostrud looking to get aboard for a third time. Takes a rip at that one. Now the count's full. Set to deliver and does. That one is certainly a ball. With the toss of the bat.
I'm adding for the Firebirds. Second base for number 14.
To first.
Cody Breckling.
So first batter is aboard for Carthage. Cody Breckling. Now in there. 1-for-1 on the day with a walk. Takes the first strike. One. Drives him down and delivers. That one is hit. Center. Should be caught as he makes his way over to right. Jara. Pulls it down for the first out of the inning.
Colin Callahan.
Colin Callahan now step up. Hit, strikeout. Colin stays so far. Toss back first. Bottom of the fourth here. Carthage down two. And a board on first. Started to go. Kostrud did off first, but held back. Callahan. Strike 0-1. Back. Oh, now. Six batter. Presser's face. Cross over to first. Back in. Go to the count, Callahan. Swung on and missed. Strike three, second out.
Now batting for the Firebirds, the DH number 11, Joe Zulager.
Second strikeout for Bresser. As Zuliger in there with two outs. Board. Swing there from Zuliger. One for one on his day so far. Walk. RBI to his credit. One and one the count. Shifting his shoulders towards second as if he's going to go. Not. Foul back. One and two. Two down here. Bottom of the fourth. That one is hit high to right. Angling foul, however. Might be in the woods there behind Augie Schmidt Field. Got a good bat on it there, but lefty hung a bit early for that one. Presser looks to make quick work in this inning as closer goes. That one is kind of chopped between center and left. It'll drop. That'll advance Toastrude all the way to third.
Now batting for the Firebirds. Catcher number 10.
Nice hit there by Zuliger. Kind of a floater that was moving from center towards left and fell right between Dolan and Najera. Well, runners at the corners, two down. Down two. As the big bat, Asa stands in there. Got four across with his grand slam in the second. Another homer would get three in here and get part of the lead. There for a strike, one and one. That was Gase's fourth home run of the year. Towering shot to left. Four runs across the board. Two and one now the count. Presser checks over to first. Sets and delivers. Oh, and was close to grazing Gasa there. The ball, three and one. Runners at the corner. Livers. One is lifted high in center. Jarrah looks like he's under it. And he is. To end the inning. Carthage threatens. Bottom of the fourth. Had runners at the corners.
Inning.
No runs cross.
UW-Whitewater 9.
Score remains.
7.
Whitewater 9, Carthage 7 as we move to the top of the fifth. Back in a minute.
Fell into a ring of fire.
Another pitcher now in for Carthage.
And leading off
as we head to the top of the fifth, Jake
Papagallo.
A sophomore righty out of Austin Town, Ohio. First batter he'll face is Bennett Frazier. First pitch in there for a strike. Frazier, 1-for-2 on the day. Single and a ground out. That one is in the dirt. The outside part of the box. 1-1 now. Nabel pitched the inning for Carthage last time. 16 pitches. Gave up 3 earned runs on 4 hits. That one's down the middle for a strike. 1-2 now. This is Papagallo's 10th appearance on the day on the season. The fourth pitch, diving attempt by Felber, not to be. Kind of dribbles out to the outfield, but no further damage beyond a single is done. So lead batter aboard for Whitewater. Frazier has himself an infield single. That'll bring up Daryl Jackson. Double and a walk on his day. Takes ball one. Up Gallo. Second pitch is also a ball to Jackson. Up Gallo, the 4.26 ERA on the season. 19 innings, 21 hits, 16 runs, 9 of them earned. 10 walks, 12 strikeouts. Count 2-1 now, Jackson. Frazier with a modest lead, but gets back for the toss over to first. Followed by another. Jackson with a stolen base on the air on 3 attempts. That one is inside. 3-1 the count. Another toss over to first. As runner goes, slap foul, however. That'll load up the count. Here in the top of the fifth, nobody out. See if Frazier goes again here. And he does. That one is going to be a ball, however. Walk issued by Papagallo.
Not bad.
To Jackson.
Pitcher number 29. Brian Norton.
That'll put runners at first and second now. Gets nobody out. There's Ryan Norton. Third man up here in the top of the fifth. On his day. Pitch bunt was shown. Runner is going to third. He gets it. Frazier on kind of the dropped pitch. Gasa able to make his way to third. Now runners at the corners, nobody out. Heads up base running there. There for a strike. 1-1. All 2-1. At the corners. Whitewater up by 2. Runner goes first. That one's hit sharply to third. Felber's there, makes the out. Runner does advance. Jackson over to second.
Now batting for the Warhawks.
But one down now for Carthage. Go back to the top of the order. Golan again. On his day with the walk. First pitch, a strike. Single will score 2 for Whitewater here. Drop low. 1-1. Golan near the top of Whitewater's list of RBI hitters with 22 to date. That one gets away from the catcher. Frazier's going in there. Safe. Play at the plate. Bit of a risky proposition for Whitewater. But the gamble pays off. Whitewater plates another run, now leads 10-7. A few issues today. Carthage with their wild pitches or pass balls, leading runners advancing and or scoring. That one is lifted high. It's going to fall in there. Just past Toastrud. Another run will score for Whitewater. That ball was kind of in no man's land there. Neither Toastrud nor Felber. Third could make the play. And that actually will be an error on the Toastrud there. Allowing the runner to advance first, second, otherwise might not have. So 2 runs in for Whitewater this inning. They now lead by the count of 11-7. Golan will be credited with a single, but the error did allow him to advance to second by with sort of the bobble by the left fielder. Another conference on the mound here. So, Papagallo has one out so far this inning. Meyer now up for Whitewater. First pitch in there for a strike. Meyer, one for two. So far today, this walk also is credited. That one's chopped to third. Nice grab by Felber, but unable to make the throw in time. Looked like perhaps
the Warhawks first baseman number
Moser's foot might have come off that,
Randall.
But also might have been a bit behind as well. Runner does not advance. So DeMeyer gets the infield hit. Now it's first and second, one out. Donovan Brandel looked at the first pitch for a strike. Crackling tosses it to short, and the double play is turned to end the inning. But Whitewater does get two more runs across the board. And as we go into the bottom of the fifth, Carthage finds itself down 11-7. Set to come up in the bottom half of the fifth. Back in a minute.
Leading off for the Firebirds, first baseman, number 28, P.J. Moser.
All right, P.J. Moser on the bottom half of the fifth. Seven runs were scored by Carthage in the first two innings. Innings three and four, no runs. Moser takes the ball. You can't get Carthage going this inning. Those are one for two on the day. RBI to his credit. That one is hit nicely. Right between Frazier and Brandel. to the right field side.
Left fielder number 22.
Easy single there for Moser.
Jake Bolton.
He gets the inning off to a good start. For Carthage here is Jake Bolton. Taking Mike Sessa's place. Pitch high and outside. Jake Bolton, a junior out of Crystal Lake, Illinois, hits it in the same place Moser did. Diving attempt by Fraser, not going to get that one.
I'm adding for the Firebirds.
Quick work
third
for Fulton.
Number 12, Matt
to get another single on the board, get two runners on now. For Matt Felber. Back-to-back singles between the first and second baseman. Gets Carthage in business here in the bottom of the fifth. Pitch swung on a miss. Strike one. Presser is now thrown 40. Pitch, that one's bunt laid down. Presser grabs it, slides, bobbles it a bit. Does make the out at first, but runners do advance. Second
now
and
for the
third.
Center fielder number 36, Chucky Smith.
So, Chucky Smith now. See what he can do with Moser and Fulton out on the bags at second and third. 0 for 2 so far. There, fouls it back. One one now. Waggling his bat. Oh, that one does clip him. Did try to get out of the way successfully.
Right fielder. Number 19, Cody.
But however it's done, Carthage does load the bases. With only one down here in the bottom of the fifth. Looks like there is activity in the Whitewater bullpen. Carthage in business. Space is full. It's Chucky goes to give his teammate Fulton a bit of a five while we're in for a break here. No pitching change as of yet. Presser left in there, deal with bag full. As Toastrude takes a quick rip, 0-1. Two for two for Toastrude today. That one go over the plate. 50 pitch there, that fooled him a bit. 0-2 now. Third pitch on the way. Swung on and missed. Strike three.
Not bad for the
three pitches,
second
three strikes. Big out
Cody
for Whitewater.
Beckling.
now they're two down with the bases full. Freckling, one for two on the day. Hit right to second. Frazier there makes the easy play. And the inning is over. Carthage threatens, loads the bases with one down. Not able to capitalize. Bresser gets himself out of a jam for Whitewater. So at the end of five, it remains Whitewater 11, Carthage 7. So Papagallo returns for the top of the sixth. We'll face Adam Kootway to lead off this inning. One for Kootway. Two walks and a single. Was picked off in the fourth inning just before Payton ended up hitting a home run. Owen won the count. Yeah, delivers that foul first base side out of play. Oh, and two now. Hit. Tap the third base side. Foul remains 0-2. First ball, hit side there. Way hit 386 on the air. Hit swung on and missed. Strike three. First out.
I'm adding for the Warhawks.
The inning.
Designated hitter number 24.
So good start to the inning for Papagallo. Base Hayden. The blast right left for a solo home run. Time up. Two for three on the day. Single. second only meeting between Whitewater and Carthage. Delivered side again, 3-1. Last time they played, this date, 2016, Whitewater won 2-1. Different story as far as runs are concerned this game. Low, and that will walk Hayden. So, second man aboard for Whitewater. As Nazara steps in to add Whitewater 4-run lead. That one's bounced in there for a ball. On the day. Did reach on an error in the second short run. Hit sharply over the crackling, bobbled it. Barely couldn't get the runner at second. But does get the out over to first for the second out of the inning. Hayden now stands at second. Bennett Frazier scored. First pitch outside and low. 1-0. Foul inside. Frazier with a good afternoon so far, 2-for-3. Come across home twice as well. Couple singles. His efforts today. Take second ball inside, 2-1. Five unanswered runs by Whitewater. Fourth and fifth has them up by 4. One fine foul on the right, 2-2. Gallo trying to get out of this inning. Keeping the Whitewater lead 4. Next second. That one is hit in the air. Smith for the easy out. So, 0 for Whitewater in the top of the 6. They leave one aboard. No hits in the inning for Whitewater. It remains Whitewater 11, Carthage 7. Bottom of the 6 upcoming. Callahan to lead off for Carthage in the bottom of the sixth. Carson Bresser remains on the mound for Whitewater. Putting in some solid innings here. He's already gone 3 innings and thrown 46 pitches. 47th is a ball. Callahan. Ripped third base side, but foul. 1-1 now. One for three on the day for Callahan. Strikeout so far. Shot to second. Strong throw there by Frazier. Easily put down Callahan.
And
there's one down in the bottom
11,
of the six.
Joe Zuleger.
Joe Zuleger. To work. Singles to his name today. Walk. For a strike. Four ball, 1-1. It's a relatively even between the two clubs. Whitewater with one more at 11-10. There's Carthage, but that one by Zuleger is curving left. Hits the wall. Going to be a nice double in there for Joe Zuleger. A couple of feet over. Would have been
10,
over the fence.
AJ Kesa.
Still a nice rip there by Zuleger. He's having himself a great game so far. Another one with some power now stepping up. AJ Kesa. Beautiful slam in the second. Add to his RBI total here. Zuleger on second. One and one the count. One down so far. Livers. Foul. The Whitewater dugout. Esther, good work here, Whitewater. He made give up 7. He gives up none. Take down Kesa with a strikeout.
Dominating for the Firebirds. First baseman number 28, E.J. Moser.
Two down now for Carthage. E.J. Moser. Zuleger out at second. Looking to chip into this 4-run lead. Pitch taken for a ball. Moser with a couple of hits this afternoon. Left. 1 now. Some activity in the Whitewater pen. Hoping to get through this inning. Toss out to second and try to get Zuliger. Gets himself back. Zuliger stolen bases this year, or 10. Still gonna act like he is, though. That one foul back. Those are now facing 2-2. Two down here. Outside. Now a full count. That one was close. Moser looked like he wanted to, but keep himself in check. Another pitch to see here. Something more to his liking. Here it is. Swung on, though, and missed. Strike 3 ends the inning. Carthage leaves one aboard.
The score at the end of the sixth inning
and
is
after six,
Whitewater 11
remains.
Carthage 7.
Whitewater 11, Carthage 7. Top of the seventh upcoming. Back in a minute.
Pitching for the Firebirds, number 9, Chance Carruthers. Leading off for the Warhawks.
Fifth pitcher up now
three,
for
Darryl
Carthage in
Jackson.
The top of the seventh, Chance Carruthers. Papagallo made it through two innings, 239 pitches as a bunt is laid down by Darryl Jackson. Toss from Felber, not in time. Lead runner aboard. Nicely placed there by Jackson. Felber made a good throw at it. Out of time.
Ryan Norton.
Brothers, this is, he's a freshman out of Rock Island, Illinois. This will be his ninth appearance of the season. As first. First pitch to Norton is popped out. Jackson going for second. Going over right-hand side there. Jackson. Oh, manager Augie Schmidt tossed. Difficult to tell what went on the right side there as my view is blocked by the dugout. Thought the ball was caught and not. Jackson remains on. Norton remains at the plate. 0-1. Jackson going. That one is foul tipped back screen. Now it's 0-2. Jackson over there at first for Whitewater, making every effort to get to second. As Norton pumps that one up. Looks like it's in play to be caught. Gasa makes the basket catch there. A bit more difficult than it needed to be, but it works out in Carthage's favor. Yes, there's now one down. Top seven. Golden aboard now. That first pitch taken for a ball. Two, three on the day. RBI. First from Carruthers. Carruthers with a 9.50 ERA on his nine appearance. That one is in there for a strike. And Jackson makes his way to second on the stolen base. So as I said, he making his intentions known. Finally does make it over to second. Now a runner in scoring position for Skolin. One down. 1-1 the count. That one is low and outside. 2-1 now. That one go by for the ball. 3-1. Well, there's livers. That one is chopped over to Kreckling. Gets the out at first. Two down now. Oh, Jacob DeMeyer up with two outs. Jackson made his way over to third. Whitewater looking to tag on another run to a four-run lead. That one is chopped foul on the third base side. third pitch. Tips it foul. 1-2. Brothers. Hoping to put another zero on the board for Whitewater. His inning of work. That one is nicely hit between short and third. Trying to stretch out second. That will plate another run. Jackson makes his way across. Increase the lead to 5. Meyer. That one nicely. Short. Third. That'll bring up Randall. Meyer showed why his average is over 400 here with hitting like that. And he is going. That one is ripped into right by Brandel. Going to get to the wall. No problem for Brandel getting in. Excuse me, DeMeyer getting in. Brandel with a no doubt double there.
Now batting for the Warhawks.
That'll increase the lead now for Whitewater, 13-7. Just like that, Whitewater increased his lead by 2 in this inning. Still with a runner in scoring position for Adam Cootway. He swings at the first pitch, foul. Randall at second. They're hitting into 2 double plays this game. His presence known with that double. Cootway hits it in center. Should be an easy out, and it is. Chucky Smith brings it down. But 2 runs across for Whitewater. Now with 14 hits on the day, 13 runs. Carthage now finds themselves down by 6 as we head to the bottom of the 7th. Peanuts get Cracker Jack. Come on back.
Leading off for the Firebird, left fielder number 22, Jake Bolton.
All right, Jake Bolton started off in the bottom of the 7th. Down 6. Bresser remains pitcher for Whitewater. He delivers first pitch strike. That one is hit. Oh, the outside diving play by Nazera does not get him. Nice hit there. Jake Bolton. That's the way to start off the inning. That'll bring up Matt Felber. sun might be an issue. Nope. Meyer gets him. First pitch is hit flat out for Felber. One down now for Carthage.
Batting Firebird for 35. Logan Grimm.
Logan Grimm now taking the place of Chucky Smith. Logan Grimm, a sophomore out of Shoreview, Minnesota. This will be his 19th game this season. As a balk, I believe, was issued there. So that'll move Fulton over to third. Grimm hits at the center. He's center fielder headed back. Gets under it. Runner does tag. Fulton cuts the lead to 5 for Whitewater.
I'm adding for the Firebirds. Right fielder number 19.
This is now
20,
empty.
Ostrud.
Sacrifice for Grimm. Gets us back to the top of the order. Ostrud. That's the first pitch for a ball. Low, 1-0. That one hit under the leg, between the legs of the pitcher there. Sharply hit right up the middle.
Now batting for the Firebird. Second baseman number 14.
For a single for Toaster.
Cody Harkling.
His third hit of the game. So Carthage trying to chip its way back. Harkling now. As it looks like a new pitcher is finally coming aboard for Whitewater. Wrestler put in 4 2/3 work through 68 pitches. Gave up 6 hits and only 1 run. As a new pitcher, number 45 for Whitewater, Eli Frank. He has a 4.67 ERA. This is his 9th appearance on the season. Giving up 22 hits. Over 17 in the third inning. 9 runs given up. 20 strikeouts on the air. The 5.
Now pitching for Hawks. 45, Eli Frank.
Batter. Frank is out of Bayport, Wisconsin. 6'3", a sophomore. Put 2 out for Carthage. Bottom of the 7th. Crackling set to try his hand at chipping into this lead. Looks like we're set to go here. on the day. Hit the center, walk, fly out in the ground out. First one, 1-0. Is hit high to the right side, foul. And he makes the catch behind the dugout, couldn't see it. Fortunately, that ends the inning for Carthage. One run is tacked on by Carthage. Now down 13-8 as we head to the top of the eighth. Back.
Pitching for the Firebirds, number 34, Jake Hartman Jr.
So the sixth pitcher for Carthage enters the top of the eighth. Jake Hartman Jr. 6'4" righty out of Crystal Lake, Illinois in his sophomore season. Carthage pitching. They made it one
for the Warhawks,
inning
the
or two innings.
M.
Brothers, the last pitcher up, made it an inning. Give up two runs on three hits, 17 pitches. First batter up is Sam Payton. High up near the head, ball one. Payton, 2-for-3, the homer. One is lifted out of play on the right side. 1-1. Then delivers. Another one hit foul behind the screen. One and two now the count. That one's in there. Called strike. First out of the inning. Drop that one in nicely. Got him looking. So, second batter up now for Whitewater. Sarah. He is 0-for-4 on the day. right back to Hartman, though. Jogs over to first and underhands it for the easy out. Two up, two down.
Now batting to the Warhawks, 7, Andy.
Andy Thies now in his first appearance on the day. Freshman out of Tallahassee. That's the first pitch for a ball. Big cut there. Successful 1-1. Low, 2-1. This is 11th appearance. 3.33 average. Another big cut. 2-2. Two out. Hartman looking to go. Three up, three down. In the picture, big strike. Got him looking. Two strikeouts for Hartman that inning. It is 1-2-3. Go to the bottom of the eighth. Carthage down by 5.
Pitching for Hawks, number 17, Austin Baker. Leading off for the Firebird, shortstop, number 31,
Colin Whitewater. It's in with another pitcher, Austin Baker. Just one, Eli Frank. One batter, got his one out. His afternoon, Colin Callahan. Begin the eighth for Carthage. One for four on the day. Second pitch inside for a ball, 2-0. Here delivers, that one is hit in the air to center. Catch made near the warning track. One down. Got a hair two under that one.
Number 11. Go, Zuliger.
Go, Zuliger. See if he can get the inning started. Rally caps in order. He looked at ball one. Fouled back. 3 on the day. Double and a couple of singles. Tipped that one. Foul. 1-2 now. They're doing his job well as DH. That one into right. Routine play for Whitewater. Two up, two down. Bottom of the eighth.
Now batting Firebird, number 16, Riley Hughes.
So, new batter in Carthage. Riley Hughes. That's the first strike. Takes the place of Gesa. Quickly down 0-2 is Hughes with two out. And three pitches, three strikes. Hughes down, ends the inning. Three up, three down. Not across.
Score at the end of the eighth inning is to the eighth. Whitewater 13 and Carthage.
Whitewater
eight.
13, Carthage 8.
Now pitching for the Firebirds, number 2, Trey Destro. Leading off for the Warhawks, number 3, Daryl Jackson.
Well, top of the ninth. Wouldn't be top of an inning if I wasn't announcing a new pitcher. And in there is Trey Zastro. Lefty junior out of Manitowoc. First pitch for a ball. It's Daryl Jack. One and one. Jackson, that one. That one is ripped to the right field side. He'll stretch that out for two. Stand up double for Jackson. Second double of the day. Damage.
Now adding the Warhawks, number
in
one.
The eighth spot
Gabe
for
O'Brien.
Whitewater. Batter in for Whitewater here. Gabe Bryan. takes over Golan at the top of the order. Gets away. Jackson easily in there at third. So Whitewater in position to add on to their 5-run lead here. Nobody out, top of the ninth. Outside, 2-1. Low, 3-1. Swung on and missed. Full count now to O'Brien. Here is struck some out. Got him looking. Nicely delivered there by Zastro. For the first out of the inning.
Now batting for the Warhawks for 9. Eric Hughes.
So Eric Hughes subbing in for Whitewater. One junior out of Janesville. First pitch going outside, ball one. Also low, ball two. Whitewater's, they spread their runs out throughout the game. Down 3-0 after the first. Quickly jumped up. Top six. Carthage battled back at the end of that inning. 4 runs. 7-6. Since the top of the fourth. Which is in there for a strike. Since the top of the fourth. Whitewater's held the lead for 9-7 after 4. Haven't pushed it in. Full count now. That one is ripped up the center field. 1 run comes across. Almost hits Astro. Thankfully it didn't.
Now batting for the Warhawks, number 13, Jacob DeMeyer.
Hughes. The hard hit single up. Second base. DeMeyer is now aboard. 1 down here in the top of the ninth. He hits that high at the right. Over to make the catch. He's the right fielder. Now 2 down.
Warhawks, number 19, Matt Harmon.
Another new batter in for Whitewater. 19, Matt Corman. 6-foot senior out of Waterford. He hit that foul on the right side. Whitewater up 6. Top of the ninth. Second pitch is in there for a strike. 0-2. Runner goes. still looking for more here. Two down by six. Two delivers high. Two. On the way, sit high, between left and center. Postroot has it. Ends the inning. Whitewater does tack on another run. Two take their lead up to six, 14 to eight. Last chance for Carthage as we head to the bottom of the ninth. Down 14 to eight.
Pitching for the Warhawk, 24, and Payton leading off for the Firebird, 28, P.J. Moser.
Oh, bottom of the ninth, Sam Payton makes his way from the DH spot to pitcher to base. 28 for Carthage. Jay Moser. Pitch in there, first strike. 1-1. He's ripped that. Tipped. Not tipped, but second strike is on the book for Moser, 2-for-4 on the day. That one's inside, 2-2. Water shading a bit to the right side. And that one is hit high into left. To be there, it made it a little more difficult than it needed to be at the game, but
now batting for the Firebird,
makes
number
the out.
22, Jake Bolton.
Jake Bolton now aboard. Ripped a double the last time he was up. Another hit in there off the first pitch. Bolton. Two appearances, two
number
hits.
12, Matt Elger.
In and going for Carthage. Elger, three on the day. Pitches outside for a ball. Delivers ball. Two and 0 to Felber. crossing here. Down six. That one's in there for a strike. 3-1 now. One down. Bottom of the ninth. Good foul to the right side. Full count now. Elger strikes out. From 3-0 to a strikeout.
Now batting for the Fireworks. Number 37.
Two down now.
Xander Hobbs.
Batter in for Carthage. Xander. They have his name on my Xander Tubbs. There he is. 1-1 the count. Another swing on 1-2. Carthage on the last strike. Cubs does here. Out. Another spin on. That'll end the ball game. So, Carthage. Balls.
Your final score from today's game is UW-Whitewater 14.
Whitewater
Carthage
14.
Eight.
Carthage 8.
Join us again on Saturday.
16 hits
April
for Whitewater.
For a
14 for
North
Carthage.
Central College,
couple of errors.
Starting at noon. Thank you for attending.
Carthage left 9 men on
base.
Whitewater 7.
Please drive
37
home
at-bats for Carthage. 41 for Whitewater. Unfortunately, Carthage goes down. 15-8. Next game Carthage plays April 28th, this Friday at Wheaton College. Back into conference play. And then Saturday, here at Augie Schmidt Field, it's a doubleheader. Carthage North Central College. That starts at 12. Second game at 4. Until then, thanks for joining us for Carthage College Baseball.